Here's good. That line was really nice. 15-8. Zeros?
No, no. 85-90.
Okay. What did I throw in my last one? Zeros. And I was tight, but we were going this way. Isn't it quicker that way?
I just put it like that.
Okay. 85?
No, 90.
90. What was yours? And it was back line. Yeah, okay. Yeah, first one down the path. Okay. Sorry, getting in your way there. I thought she was in the middle of sliding, so I was like, brakes, brakes, brakes.
That was here, 14-9. It was coming up, but it would still be side of button. I was middle of 8. Also, she stopped the rock at the tee line and then put it through our path. No, the back. Like, because I've been stopping them at the tee line and moving them around this way. So she stopped at the tee line and moved it back on this side. So I just had you here. I think we can probably go here. We're gonna cut the path down a bit. It's just not moving. Like, Kristen's would have maybe got side of button, but so it might be a touch fresh in there. Give it a real good sweep down that middle side. What are you thinking? 14-4?
I was gonna say 14-2. I don't
know. Okay.
Has a 14-2 got us there yet?
Yeah, probably not. Okay, 14-2. Be tons. Give it a good scrub though.
I grabbed this prematurely. They're short, so.
Was I tight or did I throw it away? Okay, maybe just an inch more because that was starting to move. What was that, 13-9? I'm going to take an inch more.
Hasn't caught the curl yet. Hasn't caught the curl yet. Okay, line's not terrible.
Because that was starting to move.
Stop.
That was a 13-9.
Stop.
where would it have ended up? Or did that? But you didn't heavy clean, really? Like, it wasn't like a heavy brush?
22 and a half.
Okay, so I can throw like 4 feet less. I think it'll be easier if we have to sweep it there. I'm just taking an inch less,
that
too.
One for your split?
Or an inch more, I mean, sorry.
Okay, sir.
Okay, let's make it good. Maybe a little bit further out.
I got a way lighter split, but maybe you extended a bit
I did
more.
Extend a bit more.
It's a little more than 63
I didn't think I extended that
half,
much, but so we were like closer to the path that you guys were throwing on rather than that first one I was really on an inside pass. Sorry, guys.
Okay.
Good curling.
Curling.
Good curling.
Curling. Good curling.
Good curling.
Curling.
Good curling.
Good to see your back.
Better. Good curling.
Good one, Jones.
Okay, dokey.
Yeah,
sorry.
Just like, well,
I think I was on that.
Have a good game.
Very hot.
I think I was that path that was a little bit further out, too, that was a little bit quicker.
I've got lots of layers.
Yeah. Yeah.
Three shirts.
Okay. Let's just play it easy for the first little bit. Don't suck. Make more shots than the other team. Score more points than the other team. And STP. And TG.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here inside the Kelowna Curling Club. Draw number 4 here at the Sunset Ranch. Kelowna Double Cash. Jordan Kiss here with you for this one. It's Team Work versus Team Thompson in women's action here tonight. Team Thompson will have the hammer based on the draw of the button at the end of warm-ups. And leading us off here for the defending BC Women's Champions, it's Jen Rusnell.
Hard for paint. Hard for full paint. 14-9. Hard, 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 hard. Good sweep. 14-9.
And that will come into the top of the 12 foot. And leading us off here for Team Thompson, it's Lynette Nordic.
Clean. Clean. Yep. Yep. Hard. Jody's way. Yep. Your way, Jones. 9-1. Good sweep. Good judge.
And they will hit that one and sit again in the 12 foot. It's the second time these two teams have met this season. Last coming at the last event at the Kamloops Crown of Curling, where Sarah Wark defeated Carla Thompson 6-3. All time head-to-head between these two skips. Carla Thompson has 8 wins to Sarah Wark's 4.
Yep, hard, 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 hard. Right up, you still got to push hard. Hard, 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 hard. Good sweep. Okay, well, 10-4.
And hit right from Jen. His man will roll to the other side of the 8 foot. Team Thompson 0-1 so far. They played their first game early this afternoon. They lost on the final shot to Team Slattery. Team Mork 1-0, defeating Team Giles in the same draw. Hit was made there from Kelsey Jones, who's filling in here for Team Work this weekend, their normal second. Carly Sandwith was in Quebec coaching the BC mixed team at Nationals, where they just fell short of the playoffs. Quebec, the home team, I believe going undefeated to win earlier today. So. A shout out to Quebec, but we'll give a shout out to our BC team. Skip Cam DeJong, third Taylor Reese Hansen, second Alex Horvath, and lead Mariah Coulom for a great performance. Split it out, so open house here for Team Thompson and Amanda Guido. Team Thompson out of the Kamloops Curling Club. Team Thompson coming off a third place finish at the Crown of Curling, losing where they lost to Corinne Brown, the eventual champion in the semifinal. They also had a third place at the King Cash as well, and their other event, the Prestige in Vernon, they failed to make the playoffs. So that rock from Amanda will come a little short of the house. And for Team Work, I guess they... kind of tied for third with Team Thompson after losing in the semi-final in Kamloops as well to Team Han of China. This freaking thing now says it looks like they appear to be missing a red rock. Looks like they found it over on a sheet 9.
Do you
want
to grab that? This is actually... Whatever. I'm just kidding. She'll do it after, I think, is the plan.
Oh. So, the case of the missing rock has been solved, and we'll move on here. Kristen Pilot, the third for Team Work.
13-9. That's kind of funny. We found it. I don't know what they're missing, though.
Well, they had extra, I think.
Oh, okay, okay.
The draw is made to the 4 foot,
no,
and for Jody Brennan, a open hit. So bring the missing rock down. on it right away.
It's gone. It's gone.
And it will go on by. This is the fifth and final event on the BC Women's Curling Tour, presented by Bel Air Direct Insurance and Best Western. And of course, tour points are up for grabs for a automatic spot in provincials. Teamwork already clinching a berth because they are the defending champions. Now, currently leading the BC Women's Curling Tour is Team Brown, who were in Nova Scotia this weekend playing in the Tier 2 event of the Grand Slam, and they came up short in the semifinals. It was in a Team Murphy 8-5. But a very good performance from Team Brown, who have won two events on the tour this season in Abbotsford and Kamloops.
Kelsey, hard Kelsey.
Now,
teams
can also qualify through the BC Curling Tour through CTRS points. So the team with the most CTRS points that haven't already qualified through the BC Curling Tour or received an automatic spot will get a place in provincials. I'm not too sure exactly how it's worked out. So right now it could be if, say, Team Brown's leading the BC Women's Tour, they also lead on a CTRS point. So if they choose to go in by CTRS points, again, not sure how that's decided. Then Team Thompson, who's currently in third place right now, might get a spot based on tour points. So a very important weekend for Team Thompson, as they're could be battling out with the Team Richards for an automatic berth in provincials, which will be in Cranbrook in January.
Otherwise, we go here.
Yeah, just soft.
We might leave her that double and roll again. Even. Well, if we knows they're rolling under.
For Sarah Work, looking to finish off their tour season on a high note here with a win.
It's not,
of course,
as much
women's playdowns coming up in a few weeks' time, in the first weekend of December, and Abbotsford men's and women's playdowns will be taking place. Always a huge advantage to avoid the playdown process.
It's so loud.
Gives yourself a chance to maybe some extra practice time, and always nice to be assured that you have a spot in provincials. Playdowns, anything can happen. You see, sometimes you see anywhere teams who are favorite
here
to qualify don't
Can
even
it, who threw it here?
Make it through.
Okay. Give me a touch less. It's not moving as much.
So
as
we're on to Skip Rocks here in the first dance. So
yeah,
an open hit here for
nice.
Team Work to sit two without the hammer. Is made.
I should have kept the ice the same.
I guess we just hit it.
I should have kept the ice the same. Moved a lot at the end, eh?
Better
than totally.
So again, an open hit here for Carly Thompson.
I think it was about a 10-ish.
It felt a bit hot when like, it sounded like it hit hard.
Okay.
So maybe a bit up, but it
was still moved a lot at the end.
Speaks fine.
Yeah,
so loud.
It's too loud.
There's Carly Thompson, a former BC Women's champion herself.
Hers was 7-9. Her second was 4-3. I'm like,
yeah.
I'm like, you just told her 14-9, and now you're one eye throwing feet to throw.
Well, she fixed it. She saw me leaning.
Like, no, 13-9.
Yeah, it's too loud. Oh, your dad and Taylor here. The escape. Oh, really? Oh, funny.
Come to the nose, a little roll in towards the middle, but like another open hit here for Sarah. Try to roll away a little bit.
Yeah, totally. Like right here would be great.
Again, no, okay.
Yeah, 10.
She did get a time. It felt, yeah. Roll your way, Jen. You might have to scrub this one a little bit, Kels, to hold it there. It seems like it's finishing at the end, but it's not moving as much. I'll try and say stuff to you guys after I let it go if I see her do anything.
So Sarah already an early idea of what she expects the ace to do here in the first end. Expecting this one to have some movement to it.
Yep, go, go, go. Whole way, the whole way. Wow! Wow!
You try to roll the other way here behind the guards. We'll roll to the 4 foot.
Sorry, I was tight. I think just like a 10.5.
So,
sorry.
A little more delicate of a shot here for Carla. Now she's got to worry about that one on the top of the 8 foot.
Yep.
Might get it in her way. But hit and stick in the 4 foot.
Holy
and you'll
like
get your one here in the first.
My last one was 9.
8 ends of play, of course. No time limit, no timeouts. Yep. 5 rock rule and extra end if needed.
Yeah.
So last rock here in one.
Too, we have to make sure the whoever's throwing tells the sweeper what the person in the house is doing. If it's like an urgent thing. Because it's too loud. Like if we scream something, they're not gonna hear it.
Running now to get by the top red one, and it'll just get by and hit right on the nose. And Team Thompson will take their single here in the first end. They'll have the early 1-0 lead at the Sunset Ranch, Kelowna.
Miles ago, Jeff.
Shouldn't we be going faster?
Nah, with Bel Air Direct, you can save money on your optional car insurance by driving safely.
Up to 25%.
Slow and steady, Jeff.
Save up to 25% for safe driving on your optional car insurance with Bel Air Direct.
This isn't just a beer. This is a double-aged, never-back-down, full-of-heart Western beer. This is a beer brewed by 16 guys who risked it all. Original 16. Underdogs since 1989.
Lots of hand signals.
We're back here inside the Kelowna Curling Club. You heard Sarah Wark. Kind of at the end of the first end there, say that's a little loud in here, and that's because all 12 sheets here in Kelowna are being used. 12 sheets. I don't know if that's an ice maker's dream or a nightmare. I think that's a nightmare. I mean, Marcia do ice as well, and I couldn't imagine pebbling 12 sheets. 6 sheets is already hard enough to do, let alone double that. But 12 sheets here in the Kelowna Curling Club, all of them in action. Every team in this event, men's and women's, is playing. I might try to do one quick run through of all the games, but that's a lot. That's 11. We'll see what I can do. We'll do a quick run through. Sheet 1 to 12. So men's are on sheet 1 to 6. Women 7 to 12 over on sheet 1. Team Jonice versus Team Berklet from Seattle. Sheet 2. It's Team Wood versus Team Tardy. And sheet number 3. Team Dangerfield versus Team Jackson. An all-Victorian matchup. Team Jackson, it's their third game of this event so far. All 3 of their games have been against a fellow Victoria team. Is that the coincidence? I don't know. Just maybe an interesting fact. If I'm Victoria and they're in Kelowna, they've only played Victoria teams so far. Over on sheet 4, it's Team Cotter minus Jim Cotter. Of course, Steve Laycock skipping. Pat Simmons, 2-time Brer champion, sparring for them this weekend. They're playing on Team Montgomery. Sheet 5, Team Longworth versus Team Medford. And to wrap up the men's side, sheet 6, Team Wenzik versus Team Richard. And here on women's side, sheet number 7, it's Team Richards versus Team Hedima. And we could give a special shout out to Team Hedima lead Patty Wallenham, who's celebrating a birthday today. So happy birthday to Patty. On sheet 9, it's Team Ebby versus Team Margarian of Russia. Sheet 10,
that's
it's Team Slattery versus Team Giles. Sheet 11. Team Kaufman from Alberta versus Team O of Korea. And Sheet 2. It's Team Kiwana against Team Gushilak. I didn't say all teams are in play, but the one team that isn't here is a Team Bushi. They're not playing tonight. Apparently there's 13 teams on the women's side. So almost everybody's playing tonight, but it's a packed house here in Kelowna. Jordan Kiss with you, and it's a lot to go through.
Room? Yeah, gotta go line! Hard line! Really hard line! Really
so the last little lead rocks here.
Push hard. Really hard line.
Jen
go
trying to play
line up, right
a... kind of draw a freeze to the one in the back of the forefoot here.
Good brush, you guys.
And we'll get there for shot stone. If you do want an update on any of the scores, you can go to curlingzone.com. Or line scores are constantly being updated. I don't know if I'll run down the games again. That's a lot, as I mentioned. We'll just focus on Sheet 8 tonight. As that rock from Amanda will nick the guard and roll over to the right. Slightly open things up, but not too much. So Team Wart could put another one in there, but they will only sit one. Maybe play a little bump. Looks like that's what Sarah is going to call here. So she's going to ask Kelsey for back line weight. Try to get to the nose and maybe bump the yellow one back a little bit and sit two when it's all said and done. The guard.
That's fine.
But it will hang on into the 8 foot
five.
There. That's a pretty nice result.
The
importance of throwing the right weight there, you know. Throw that anymore, you're probably through, but you're able to make something of nothing. Kind of freeze right on top here for Amanda and Team Thompson.
Stop.
And we'll come to rest just short.
I have
the red one.
Right,
almost kind of lines it up right now for a Team Work to throw some weight at it and remove both yellow rocks and sit three. One's all over the guard. They're going to try to make something of it again. And they'll hit it right on the nose. So, and kind of put one on top, maybe just short. Team Thompson would love to force Teamwork to a single point here. And of course, that red one isn't going anywhere, so you don't want to, you can't move it around. So third rocks, Jody Brennan. Try a little wick off the guard here. Try to get in front, and they will, and they'll come in. And both teams getting a little lucky here in this second end. Again, angles still are pretty good here for Team Work, but that's a kind of lonely red one there in the forefoot. Sandwich pretty good. So again, they're going to try to do the same thing. You can see less of the yellows. I'm going to try to smooth some granite around here, Kristen Pilot.
Yes! Really hard! Really hard! You still got it! Push hard! Go, go, go! Okay, whoa, 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 whoa! Kelsey, watch that red.
Got it. Will tick the guard and.
Yeah.
Again, not much Team Thompson could do with this red one without jamming it. We could try to pick it clean.
I mean, we could go here. 10-2.
They could corner onto it, even if you're short, that's fine. And they're going to come right in the top of the 4 foot there. Not much harm you can do to yourself here. Well, I'm not too sure if you want to leave Team. I guess if you do leave Team Work with that open hit, then the red will be removable on your next one. Unless they play some soft weight at it, just like a tap, tap, freeze kind of thing.
It's got a curl.
Now this one is heavy. And we'll slide to the back of the 12-foot. Now Sarah's taking a look at who shot stone right now.
I got 14-1, so I didn't get like 15 or anything.
It looks from our above
I think you made them
overhead cam that... The red stock, red rock is a shot stone. Looks more obvious from where the angle is, because the center of the camera is kind of like at the top of the 12 foot, not directly over the button T line area. So the angle is a little off, but that is what we are given with here at the Kelowna Curling Club. We've been able to tap into the overhead cameras here, which we haven't been able to do for our events in Kamloops and Vernon, pretty much everything except the Anita Cochran Rural City. It is nice to have those overhead cameras.
So you're going to be light on your next one, if anything. It's just kind of tough because it's queued up. I don't want to move it.
Yeah, totally.
But
that's what Sarah's saying. It's queued up. It's too nice for him. You don't want
to... If I can blast on my last, we might be able to get second shot over here.
Cool. Marcio, our producer, director, will... kind of show off our little new camera over here.
I might end up having two shots at this, depending on what they do.
It's almost perfect.
Like if
still a couple of kinks to work out, but
they might breathe.
Excited
here.
To have this
and then this goes
really add
that.
To the viewing experience for yourself watching.
We could do this and just move this to here.
And you can play soft weight at it. Don't have to throw it hard.
Because then we might have a shot at these two after. Yeah, like we can roll right over here. And then hopefully we don't move this too far. Just hack, Max.
Yes, So they're saying hack weight. Just kind of tap this one up a hair. And you don't throw too hard. Then they're going to try to roll as far over as they can behind these corner guards in this area. And still looking to set up a big end here for teamwork. Still possible. With the way that the yellow ones are lined up, you will have a... if you have a chance, you could have a double or a triple.
Clean! Whoa! Yep! Hard! Really hard right up! Really gotta push! Really gotta push hard, guys! Really hard! Go, go, go! Kelsey, hard roll, Kels. Hard roll, right over. That's good.
They will hit, great bump
shot.
Things around, and will the sit there, but will leave a double.
13-8.
Maybe 10. Even a red triple. Double for sure. We'll see where this one ends up.
Them the double, but they're rolling.
No, it could... No, hit that one. Maybe clip this one on the underside, but then it might jam into there. Lots of angles to work with. Maybe I'm overthinking this.
13-8. Yeah, like at
least hitting. Totally. But definitely a double for sure. Here, Sarah did say that. You know, good thing is that they will roll away. And looks like the way the yellows are lined up in the house that you will have a chance to get rid of two of them for sure. I don't think you're going to be able to get all of them out. Well, Carla has to make this one first, but she's a little wide. And we'll hit her yellow one that's there, and the red will spin to the 8 foot, but it's Team Thompson sitting... One. Looks like Team Work is first, second.
Like it'd be nice if we can over curl.
Are we one and three?
Maybe third.
And
maybe fourth.
And I don't want to leave her this double.
And the angle of the overhead cam isn't helping too much.
What was that one though?
She could just guard. Well. Still, though, we're a little bit high, and she's got this into here. Let's just throw 11 at it. Try and get that over curled a little.
I didn't miss it.
So I'm going to hit this open one here.
It's not great either. But.
We're sitting two. And four. So we want to try and get across the face if we can. So I'll just throw an 11. It's moving.
So Sarah confirming that they're sitting second shot and fourth shot. I'm going to go just across the face here. Try to roll behind the yellow rocks.
Lumbering. Okay, 11. It is moving pretty nice here. Whoa, whoa, Kelsey.
And this one, like Carla's, is wide. Needs to curl to hit a piece of it. And she will nudge hers out, and it's
really good
team Thompson sitting one now at the top of the 8 foot. Looks like
Sorry,
it's
just
one.
Sorry, I was looking at the rock.
I think Rock is sitting second. But nonetheless, I like just drawing to it. Yeah, what Jody kind of signaled there. Or was it Carla? What was Carla? Just freeze right into those red ones
there.
And you force to a single. Emma Thompson throwing her final rock here in the second inning.
I missed the time. Did you get it?
One is
yep,
light.
What did you get?
Maybe a little confusion on the Team Thompson side after that. So, looks like, is there a shot
Where's
for
right
four
this?
Here for Sarah?
Well, I think Finn is still going here, but we're still good here. Get the flop.
I think the question is, where will where will this rock end up? Because you're going to have to hit it into here.
Yeah.
And if it deflects into here, it's probably going to be three. I think it's worth a shot. As long as it doesn't jam on the red one, which I don't think it will.
Because we want to make sure this goes back.
Like just
Are we
7/8,
okay, if we hit notes,
3/4.
Okay.
That could be a four-ender here.
I think so too.
I
okay,
think
so
just
no
hit it that
good.
Way. You don't have to worry about who's closer
let's
right
play
now.
For
let's
this,
let's
though.
Do that. That's what we're gonna do. Yeah, play the hit.
Safe side 9. I think it'll move a bit. Okay.
Normal weight shot here from Sarah. They've played this spot a couple times already earlier in the end, so they should know what it does out here, where to put the broom.
But if we get just a touch high side and get that double and roll your way a little bit, we'll be 1-2-3. So let's play for that roll, but if we nose, that's fine. Yeah.
Just want to make a curl. She will get a double, avoid everything, and will roll out, but it will be a score of 3 for Sarah Wark and her team here in the second inning. They'll have the 3-1 lead over Team Thompson through 2 ends here at the Sunset Ranch, Kelowna. Double K.
My hearing isn't that bad.
Stop making excuses and do something about your hearing loss. Connect Hearing offers solutions that are discreet, reliable, and cost-effective. Book your free hearing test today.
And number 3, get it underway here over on sheet 8 at the Kelowna Curling Club. It's the Sunset Ranch Kelowna Double Cash. Fifth
good,
and final
good.
Event 13. On the BC good. Women's Curling Tour presented by Bel Air Direct Insurance and Best Western, the official hotel of Curl BC.
The one at the back because I thought we were jamming right into it.
Jordan Kiss with you for this one. Thank you for joining me here on this Saturday night
that
on
a
long
a
weekend.
Scary. Just tens move so much. That's why I actually
fourth game
was
of the day.
Pack, like, do I have enough ice? It did.
Two more on tap tomorrow for sure.
Good push.
And then
it was.
Still
it was
yet to be
creative,
decided what could happen for the evening games. There's no set playoff draw yet, so there is time allotted tomorrow evening for tiebreaker games. So if there are any tiebreakers, we'll have at least one of them for you.
14 and a half.
But if there are no tiebreakers, hopefully that the quarterfinals then will go on tomorrow night instead of Monday morning. But if not, then we'll have an off night on Sunday. We'll have three games, quarters, semis, and men's, or finals. I believe we're doing the men's final. I want to talk to you with Jeff Richard a few weeks ago, who was organizing this event. I talked to him in Kamloops. And I believe he said we are going to be doing the men's final. So safe to assume we will be broadcasting the women's
Mine's
semifinal.
Really nice.
So still lots of curling to go. We'll
15-1.
Wait till it actually
nice
happens
talk,
to decide or to figure out when and what games we will be doing. But if you want to keep a tab on that, follow CurlBC on Twitter at CurlBC. I'm running the CurlBC account right now, so I'll have all the schedule updates for you there. Also, check out CurlBC on Instagram and Facebook. You can get an update on all the rest of the games as well that we will be streaming. And also, maybe after this one's over, you might want to watch some previous games we've done here on CurlBC TV. So you can just go right to our channel. If you haven't already, click the subscribe button. Through the lead rocks here in the third end. Sarah Wark and her team sitting quite nicely. There's Kelsey Jones, the spare.
Yep.
Fill-in for Carly Sandwith, who was in Quebec coaching the BC mixed teams at Nationals.
Keep going.
Yep, try to bring
going,
this one
going,
in here.
Keep going. Okay, that's good.
And if that's all
15
good.
15-1.
Look on the top, the 12-foot, partially buried. Not a lot to work with right now for Team Thompson. So try to run this yellow one here, clear some reds out of the front. The one, they'll hit the yellow one and it'll come all the way through the house. So teamwork, gonna put up another guard.
We want to touch center. Okay, well,
try
we'll
this one on the center
far.
Line here,
16,
just a high guard,
right
and
top.
That's a great shot from Kelsey. And kind of the same thing here for Team Thompson. Carla wanted the exact same thing from Amanda, so they're just going to ice her a little differently here.
No.
This one's a little wide. She will peel the top one off. Sir, we're going to throw up another guard.
Kristen
Pilot,
and
as we
like
are on the third rocks in the third end. Gonna be another high center guard.
Okay, we got a touch center. Go, Kels. Hard, Kels. We want a touch center. Touch center, touch center, touch center. Go, go, go. Every inch, push hard. Go, go,
and
go,
they
go,
wanna
go, go, go,
guard
go, go.
The one that's right in the center line there, because that's the one that Team Talbot can make. Can hit to make a double peel. And that'll get him out of this end. So those rocks are not helping Team Thompson at all. And Jody Brennan. Will get two, but she will stick her shooter up there. So another chance for Team Rourke to play a little different kind of guard here. He can even go right in. Even if you're short behind the yellow one, that's fine. Go right in, top of the 8 foot.
Here's okay.
Pilots, and that will
16-2.
Rock off the yellow guard, but still not the end of the world. There's no port.
I don't think we have it.
But
yeah.
A chance maybe to go yellow, red, red, and remove that rock off the button. And Team Thompson now just trying to open things up, make sure they have a chance to score. Blank is still a possibility. Curl and we'll go yellow red and sit right there at the top and halfway in the free guard zone.
Okay.
So Team Warwick could do the same thing here as
yeah,
they wanted to in their last and
like if we play what I just
draw.
Called, they're just running that all day. Yeah, they're gonna get
come
something.
Down the right
yeah,
side from this angle here
yeah.
And
should have a shot on my
she
draw in on top.
Freeze, and then we freeze on top of her.
Or we guard.
Yeah.
And she's shooting for one.
Yeah. So
well,
even
she
if
needs
we're
to
like
throw it. She needs to
here.
Looks like they're gonna guard their own.
Unless she wants to.
Like just a little cross.
Why? Ina saying is you guard.
Hmm? Maybe, but that's a hard run.
Carla most likely tries to peel again.
No, I was just thinking
they're saying if she
because then I feel like we're going to try and peel.
If she freezes on top,
like
decides to draw and
if
freeze on top,
wide,
then
like
you can just draw right
high,
on top
right?
Or guard it again. She's not going to have anything to score.
Yeah. So I just gave you here, and you just didn't quite make it.
And you go in. You draw in
so
here.
You here.
Might leave a triple and allow Team Thompson to escape danger here in the third end.
They have the draw
so
on this side.
What?
Yeah, no, I don't mind the guard in this situation,
draw.
I think.
And then we guard. But they've got this
it
run
really
on this side, and if
I
we come in, they're just going to run it into
brings
everything.
Brings the steel into
so
play a little more.
Like if we can get a
little higher chance now of a steal
like
happening.
A
too fancy.
You told me to throw a 10 on my last one.
What am I looking for? 17? Can you guys drag it very much this way right now?
Not really.
Okay. Just over is fine too. We just need to be covering that red.
This one for line. This one is
hard for over, guys. You guys got it.
Curling.
Hard
they
got to go.
Get it over
hard.
The hog line, which
push
is
hard, guys. Go.
This is
sorry,
not turning
guys.
Out to
that
be a
really
great
bad.
Shot from Sarah, so they're going to
sorry.
Push it to the boards.
Shoot.
You could play a straight nose double
really
on these red ones. You have to move this
shoot.
One on the button. That's the one that's really preventing you from scoring in the sand.
I don't think I'll have all of it.
Yeah.
I think Carla, being a left-hander in this situation, this might be the easier shot for her. So, of course, you're a left-hander. You're coming out of the right hack, which is on the right, of course, the right side of the sheet.
This is where I threw him.
So she's throwing the intern at this. She's going to be able to get a little more curl out of it. I think the other thing which she was worried about, she wasn't able to see maybe enough of the red one at the top of the 12 to make a double. I think it's there. You know, I'm a left-hander myself, so I think it's there. But I think Carla is pretty confident in this shot here. As this red one is... overburied. Very difficult. But if you can make it, great. This is looking very close here. You need to make it curl. They're by the guard without any problems. Now they will tap, and will they tap it enough? And looks like they will sit shot stone.
What'd you get on that?
A very nice shot there from Carla Thompson. Had a little doubt, but she proved me wrong. But for Sarah Work, she can do the same thing. Come to the nose.
No. What'd you get for splits on that? Or hogs? Oh,
we needed to move after that guard.
Looks like if she can get to the nose of it, I don't think Carla will have a shot to score unless she can draw to the side of the button. So a chance to lock down the scoring area here for Team Work.
Jen, go.
Want to make it curl. Again, Sarah's just wide. It's a lot of weight, too. Maybe a little more than what she was hoping for, and we'll go right on by.
Well, we have to come.
Now, it's not going to be an easy shot for two here for Carla.
Do we come here? Or do we?
Didn't really mirror at all the, like, back eight.
Do you like same weight? Oh, we need a little bit more, wouldn't we?
I think we need, yeah.
I thought they were saying go kind of hit this yellow thin, move it into the red one.
I don't know if we can get second.
It's not going to be easy because you're going to have to move that red one out of the forefoot, but stick your shooter in the forefoot as well. And kind of what kind of weight do you throw at that?
Yeah, I mean, we have to make sure that our shooter stays there.
Yeah.
Could try to draw to the side of the button. Looks like, you know, there is enough room if you can skinny by
can
that yellow one
with
the perfect amount
so.
Of weight. You get your two that way, but a very tricky shot here for Carla Thompson as
yeah, so probably like
it's the last rock in the third end. trying to make a curl. Is it going to curl? Look, confusion on the sweeping here. And they will get their one out of it. So a lot of some miscommunication there, but they will get their single here in the third end. So Team Thompson will trail Teamwork 3-2 through three ends here at the Sunset Ranch, Kelowna.
Miles ago, Jim.
Shouldn't we be going faster?
Nah, with Bel Air Direct, you can save money on your optional car insurance by driving safely.
Up to 25%.
Slow and steady, Jim.
Save up to 25% for safe driving on your optional car insurance with Bel Air Direct.
This isn't just a beer. This is a double-aged, never-back-down, full-of-heart Western beer. This is a beer brewed by 16 guys who risked it all. Original 16. Underdogs since 1989.
We are inside the Kelowna Curling Club.
One's okay.
And
one's
number
okay.
Four, Sunset Ranch, Kelowna
okay,
Double
whoa,
Cash.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Fifth
one's
and final event on the BC Women's Curling Tour, presented by Bel Air Direct Insurance and Best Western, the official hotel of Curling BC. Jordan Kiss here with you. Draw number four. There's final event on the women's side. It's also, I guess it's the second last event on the men's side here this weekend. Their next event is in 2 weekends in Penticton. But it's the last event for some of these teams from the men's side. It's also the last event on the junior tour this weekend over in Esquimalt on the island near Victoria. So the junior tour wrapping up.
These tours
wrapping up, it's almost play down time.
Yeah, hard,
for
hard,
men's
hard.
And women's, that's coming up soon
15,
in December. And geez, it's almost December too. It's a long ways away. So, teamwork on the play to the wings after the high center guard is thrown from the Team Thompson lead, Lynette Nordic. Curl out of this here. We'll come up a little wider. And team, we're just going to go right back on top of their own. Or maybe not. Sarah's like, let's go around instead. And they are going to go around here. Get in there first. If you go to the wings, you know, safe to say Team Thompson will just draw around. Might play the hit and roll, but I like this kind of get in the house first mentality. That's usually the strategy I play
Line's
with when
tight.
I skip.
Line! Really hard, guys. Really hard to get by. Okay, we're all over it.
Again, another overcurl.
Oh, really?
Overcurls, some undercurls.
Okay.
A little bit of everything so far in this one. Ice has been a little bit of a challenge for both of these teams. Dave Merklinger are doing the ice this weekend. His son Mike is the head ice tech here normally, but Mike isn't here. So Dave is taking over responsibility.
Keep it coming, line's great! Pull!
Thompson.
Yep.
And Aguido trying to draw it in here.
Fillet if you can. That's fine. That's
get it
fine.
In there for shot, and it will
good
be
keeping.
Short. Well, that Warp Rock, the red one there, is sitting shot stone right there in the 8 foot. And lots of room for Sarah and her team, Kelsey Jones, to draw to. Draw in, draw around, whatever you want to say.
Kristen Hart. Okay, well, holy, 14-2, super sketchy.
Nice rock. We'll come to
oh
the
man.
Back of the tee line.
It's changing.
A freezable rock here for Team Thompson. Come to the back of the button there as we get the camera to it.
Curling is hard. Curling is hard.
I mean, it was great, but just need to curl a little more. So again, soft weight bump here for Kelsey is what Sarah asked. Just tap this yellow one back a little bit. Even if you just freeze right into the pocket, that's okay.
Right in.
That one just
13-7.
Ticks the guard.
Okay.
Sarah's pretty calm on that one. Don't really hear any urgency in her voice like we usually do on those very close
it's
shots.
It's getting pretty messy. I don't know yet. Is it getting slower already? We need to start making them make the hard shots here.
Team Thompson right on top of it. Little heavy, will bump their own, but they are sitting two. But a double is there. So you possibly sit four, maybe three for sure. Maybe four. There's lots of room to that yellow one. You can even just hit and roll behind. They're gonna hit and roll the other way. You know, try to bring those two rocks on the left side into play here. Make Team Thompson worry about those as well. But even if you do make it, Team Thompson will still have that freeze to the red one. So it is going to be a hit and roll. Wait. Well, again, they will roll. They will roll.
I know.
All the way out. That was a lot of weight for that shot. I think you're gonna get away with normal on that one.
8-3.
But nonetheless, it is Team Warwick sitting three. But again, as mentioned before, Team Thompson can. can draw. Freeze on top. They're close last time they tried to play this, so looking to get a little more curl out of it. Curl, and that's gonna stagger, and that's gonna safely secure that red one in that back of the forefoot there. And if Teamwork can get another one in here, it is not gonna be good for Team Thompson. Last of the third rocks here in the fourth end.
Well, when I say they, like, that's what Lynette says.
Oh.
Maybe it just fooled Lynette. Yeah.
Keep going, guys. Keep going. Keep going. If we can roll a little bit, that's great. Really hard, guys. Really hard.
Again, this one's going to be over the, onto the two yellow ones, and it's not going to bounce, so. Opportunity for Team Thompson to get one in there really buried.
Like half open right
just
there.
Just top four, yeah.
Like crazy. And it doesn't look like it's got that carry.
And don't have to freeze.
Hey, Jen,
just
come
top,
here.
Top button. So they can afford
like
to be half
carry
open.
On the way
so that way,
I feel like we've lost our
team
carry. Like,
work
I don't know that
won't
we can
be able to hit it out.
Right
10?
Is it just fudging early? So hard.
Just like about this far from the button. Half
even on Kristen's, I gave her more than I was giving her at the beginning of the game.
Carla Thompson in the hack now. Her first rock here in four.
That's just gonna take off, I think. It's got nothing. Like, there's just no hope on these things.
So again, this
what did you feel like
rock
you threw?
Just taking off.
When I let it go, I was like, that's
awesome. Like you thought you threw like a 14-2?
I was aiming for a 15. Curling is hard.
I got a 15-6, but I don't know that that means anything.
So this spot proving
like
difficult for both
ball,
these
right?
teams. It's three in a row where it's kind of over curled and come up light.
They wanted a
like
10
right here is
three,
perfect. But if we're here,
that's okay.
Yeah. I had you here,
I feel like
which
I
is more
like
than
I'm
thinking.
Okay,
kind of, where do you put the broom in this situation? Another chance to get in there. Sit two.
And did you feel like you threw it positive?
I guess sit three.
Average? I think here.
So right now it is Team Work sitting two. You kind of forget about that.
I don't really know what it's doing. I gave Kristen ice that I thought was like extra last time and it still warped, so we took about this much more. She said she felt like she threw like a 14-8 and it was a 15-6. So I think I should aim to feel like a 14-3.
Or maybe a 14.5.
14.5?
Yeah. Like it's just curling so much
that you don't need on. Yeah. Carla started really early,
so
I'll just try to make sure that I'm positive about
the room. Based on
that
conversation, a lot of issues
with
feel, because as you...
Right. If we're
here
just
on the
top
last
12,
one,
that's fine.
Kristen's last draw, she thought, she felt like she threw it the right weight, but it turned out to be lighter than what she thought, so it could be a feel issue. Maybe the ice kind of trying to think about it here.
Well, we make the double or
like
six
you
two.
Slide on the ice, and it sometimes it feels faster than what it is, or the ice just feels slower than what it is, so it's just one of those things. And the sweepers are on this one right away. And this one is light.
I don't know.
chance to play a double here and sit buried for Team Chomps. I guess the good news is with all these laughs, all these misses, that both skips are kind of laughing at him right now. It's kind of one of those things where
line was fine.
It's just tough. You gotta.
Maybe let's just make it.
You know, it's the way the ice is right now. You gotta deal with what you got.
All right,
it's not gonna change. In this situation, a lot of times, first team that can figure out the ice is going to walk away with a victory here.
She said she was looking for a split of 85, and I threw a 4. But I thought I gave it a little bit of an extra
kick. Hit and roll in off.
Because I wanted it to run a little bit.
And sit one, and your chances of stealing are really pretty high.
Yeah.
You can make it here for Team Thompson. To make a curl, they will hit, and they won't roll far enough. How does Sarah now get in there for her two?
All right, how are we going to figure this ice out? Like weights and stuff.
Can we get here?
It could come down the right side.
Well, she's throwing.
Yeah. I think that's there.
This is kind of dangerous, I think.
I don't see much else than try to come this way to the forefoot. You got the most room.
Just try and grab the edge here. How much do I need?
So I lost my balance.
It finishes. I think we can get there.
Not a lot on this side here. That's definitely not there.
Yeah, but we thought that last.
We're gonna come down the right side, looking at it from the overhead cam.
That or give it lots of rotation so that it hangs, but then I didn't really know it was going to
needs a nice little piece of the forefoot. And you can get your two, but right now you are sitting the one for sure, so that's always a
are you guys okay with this?
Good position to be in, where you're already guaranteed a point. But you've seen.
Yeah, I can't.
You've probably
that.
Done this while you're playing or seen it done before, where some teams guaranteed a point and they end up taking it out and
they
giving up a steal.
Just biting the edge
done
of
that
the
many times myself. Not a good feeling.
So we just need an inch in the forefoot.
Okay.
What do you.
Well, I don't think that's going to be an issue for
center
work here, but with the way the ice is, you never know.
Did Kristen give you time on that last one? I don't know that those times matter anymore.
So they're just trying to figure it out here. Sarah's broom decides to take a break along the boards. So they're trying to struggling with the times
here.
Maybe
we go off splits.
I think the thing here is they haven't used this side of the ice too much.
85, okay.
All the issues they've been having have been on the other side. So we don't know if it's going to do the same out here. It might run true here and run exactly as they expect it to. Kind of what they expected the other path to be doing. See, they're on it for line and away. Looking pretty nice here. As it comes down the sheet. And this is going to be a beauty from Sarah Wark, and it is a great draw for two. And she'll have a 5-2 lead over Carla Thompson as we're halfway through this one in Kelowna. It's the Sunset Ranch, Kelowna.
My hearing isn't that bad.
Stop making excuses and do something about your hearing loss. Connect Hearing offers solutions that are discreet, reliable, and cost-effective. Book your free hearing test today.
Here inside the Kelowna Curling Club. Look at that view. Isn't that great? 12 sheets here in Kelowna.
13,
the only 12-sheeter in
that's
BC.
Nice.
That is a great view. We are on sheet 8.
Yeah. 3/4 of the way down,
Sunset,
I thought it was going to
Sunset, Ratch, Kelowna, double cash. Jordan
kind of
Kiss with you. Team Wark has a 5-2 lead over Team Thompson. We're gazing over the views here in the Kamloops Curling Club. We'll like to give a shout out to Jock Tire and everybody here for organizing the event as well as hosting. It's been fantastic. A first class facility here in Kelowna. And probably some of the best curling club food I've ever had. They got a full-on restaurant upstairs here in Kelowna, and it is honestly really good. If you're ever in Kelowna and need something to eat, because it's open to the public too. Anybody can walk in. You can walk in here 7 days a week, go upstairs and have a great meal. Trust me, it is worth it. Of course, this event hosting a lot of big events in the past. They hosted the Canadian Curling Club Championships, I believe 2 years ago here. Last year they had the World Mixed Championships in this building. And in 2020 they're gonna have the Canadian Senior,
yep.
No, not the Canadian, the World Seniors and the World Mixed Doubles Championships.
Okay, 14-9.
Here in April, as those two events coincide with one another. Of course, our producer, slash director Marcio, who's represented Brazil at 4 World Mixed Double Championships, and he's going to be off to Scotland in a few weeks to compete in the World Qualifier, and we wish nothing but the best for him and his partner as they try to qualify for the World Championships here. Big shout out here to Marcio for all the work he's done. He's the one in charge of all these camera angles. It's looking fantastic. Hopefully you are enjoying our little new setup here. Everything's just a little different everywhere we go. Also, shout out to Jessica Ingram for helping us out here behind the scenes. That rock she saw disappear, that was Jessica, everybody. That was her. She's been our scoreboard operator.
Hey, Kristen. Okay, no, leave it. Okay. 15-4. Okay.
Currently it is the Team Thompson Rock sitting one in the side of the forefoot as we get back to action here. And Amanda Guido.
Yeah.
Will come to the top of the 8 foot, just biting it. And still the yellow sitting shot, and Team Work gonna try to move some rocks around here.
Thought it would curl a bit more.
And we'll just get the top off.
Okay.
another guard here for Tubbs. I think actually maybe just going in here. So he will bounce off and roll behind the corner guard. Not fully, it is still open. So looks like there is a, you know, there is a double there for Team Bork, but it is a little thin. Hit this one that Team Thompson just threw. And we do have a final over on sheet one. Team Jonice defeating Team Berklid.
That's
a 6-1 final.
Jen! Ah, sorry guys, that's my fault.
That one will come to the nose. Still the Thompson Yellow Rock sitting one.
Ten.
He tosses it, of course, with the hammer here in five. Try to roll in. Here's a man that steps out of the way and will roll behind everything. So not too bad, but there is a red-yellow double here. We're going to try to roll a bit towards the wings. Just roll open. Want to make sure you can still get at that yellow rock in the forefoot. Last of the third rocks for Team Bork here. Kristen the pilot.
Yep. Hard, Jen. Really hard, Jen. Quick. Hard, quick.
Really hard. I'll get one. Good. And I'll get two. And then we'll open up the yellow one. That's a lonely yellow compared to the three red rocks in the house right now. So for Team Thompson, you could come to your own.
At least with that weight, it's
partially buried around the red.
I thought you were just
there's
like
not much else you can do.
Outside of my broom.
Straight.
Yeah. And it also
could
it
play
just
a hit and roll. Even hit
much.
And roll off
and
the one in the back of the forefoot. But doing that, you do risk of maybe taking your own out.
Yes, it does.
So they're going
to
kind of hit this one over here. That's
that one until it was
on the left hand side of the overhead cam. And just roll over and guard your own. That way, if Teamwork does run it back, you have one of your own rocks to raise later on. Hits made, and they will roll, will bump, and will sit in front of the your own shot still.
Comfy? I think the worst I can do is stop it, right? So just give me just a touch, like an inch of ice. Maybe just a touch less. No, that should be good.
So it looks like a straight run back here. On the nose, a little bit on the high side. You'll get both yellows moving here.
Still.
Yeah, so the same nose.
Fine.
Right on the beak here.
Hmm?
Make
yeah,
both yellows
totally.
Disappear.
Okay, guys, let's make it. Easy, comfy. Yep, hard. Quick!
This is gonna overcurl and they'll just get the one.
Okay, that's fine.
So Carla now.
Sorry, I kind of played with it.
Still sitting
the
single. I think you have to go when you.
Yeah.
You draw around the corner guard. Very unlikely it's
going
to be able to count.
I think if anything, I helped
once
it
everything
there.
Is wrapped up here in the fifth. Becerra just hits it. Well, you might leave a Becerra might leave a double. But they're going
to
guard it.
Yes.
Try to almost guarantee their single point.
I thought I did. Yeah, but I think when I let it go, like I kind of wobbled, and I thought I felt like I like dumped it a little. Yeah, maybe.
So they're going to kind of come in half barrier around the red one.
I was also trying to not throw six.
That way, if they do kind of run it in, the yellow one will jam with the one in the back, the 4 foot. Just try to line things up here to make sure at least one of the yellow rocks will stay in play. That way, you will have a shot for two on your last. This one's hanging out a little bit. They're going to try to make a curl here. Maybe tuck a piece behind and will hang
just
up
draw?
There. So.
Or do you want to play it?
Becerra does have
yeah.
the same shot if she wishes to play it. You also think of the draw. If
yeah,
you,
that
you can make
15-6.
That would be great. That's always good.
Sliding pretty good here. Yeah, I think so. I just got a 15-6 on theirs. Yeah. Okay. So close to what I threw.
Yeah.
yeah.
Like
okay, they're right on the tee line, so if we can corner freeze on them, that'd be perfect. I think just a touch more.
We're gonna corner freeze this yellow one in the house. Sit for shot rock.
Yeah.
We had a perfect draw on her last rock in the fourth. See if she can do it again here in the fifth.
I think it's got lost.
We just need this one to curl right now. Waits there.
Push, guys.
And they gotta get it there
push,
for Waits.
Push.
They left it a little too long. Will come up short. But it won't be an easy draw for Carla to get her two.
Okay.
You could tap your own yellow up
just
through the two reds there and get it in the 4 foot.
Yeah. Line
it
was
looks
great.
Like drawing to the side of the four, and that you know, yellow corner could be in the way.
I thought
way.
I felt like I threw a ton.
But it is there. Just need full four.
Hmm?
And you can
yeah.
get your two and
this is a hard draw.
Trail by one going into the sixth end.
Hmm? No, it's hard draw. The way it's cutting at the end, it's not a huge gap to get through there.
Thompson. Last rock here in five.
That looks like it's gonna go. Yeah. Oh yeah. Might even get yeah, it's nowhere close. It's tough out here.
And that's gonna overcurl. It's light. And it'll be a score of 1 for Team Thompson here in the fifth. Team Work will
real.
Have the hammer in the sixth with a 2-point lead.
It is just like
here at the Sunset Ranch, Kelowna.
Miles ago, Jim.
Shouldn't we be going faster?
Nah, with Bel Air Direct, you can save money on your optional car insurance by driving safely.
Up to 25%.
Slow and steady, Jim.
Save up to 25% for safe driving on your optional car insurance with Bel Air Direct.
This isn't just a beer. This is a double-aged, never-back-down, full-of-heart Western beer. This is a beer brewed by 16 guys who risked it all. Original 16. Underdogs since
1989. Okay, well then.
And number six here inside the Kelowna Curling Club. Team Work with a 5-3 lead with the hammer. It's round robin action here at the Sunset Ranch Kelowna Double Cash. Each team playing 4 games. 8 teams will make the playoffs. There will be tiebreakers if necessary. My name is Jordan Kiss. Thank you for joining me here on this
yes!
Saturday night on a long weekend.
All the way, all the way, all the way.
As the first rock from Team Thompson comes in.
Really hard for a piece.
Jen trying to hit it. Out and
you deserve
we'll
a beer after this.
Just, I like the sound of that. Deserve a beer. There, Kelsey Jones. There works buying Kelsey a beer after that. I like that. The way the conditions have been, it's been a mental struggle. Everybody deserves a beer for this one.
Get it
so
to center.
That Nordic. Let's try to throw the center guard this time.
Good sweep.
Center guard is made, and Team Work gonna draw around it.
Not too deep.
Ah, it's not moving.
This one's hanging out here.
Yeah, go, Kels. Yep, go. Yep, go. Yeah, I know. 14-2. Good judge.
And then we'll come to the back of the 4 foot. And Team Thompson will draw here. And this is the tricky spot we both teams struggle with in the fourth end. We'll see if we have learned from the other rocks they've thrown down here. And it was like it was just started to curl on them, and then as soon as it started to curl, it just slowed down, and there was no hope for it.
Okay, clean them! Close, yep! Yep! Hard! Hard! Hard!
This one's a looking better. Yep, they will get a bye.
Lock it on, yep. Hard. Keep it
and
coming.
They'll try
keep
to
coming,
freeze
it
to
coming.
It.
Yep. Fighting button. Great sweep.
And will
girl,
come
Amanda.
To with a button
Amanda.
For.
Amanda!
Looks like Shot Rock. Sarah just double checking that she can peel. And since she can, she will.
Yep. Really hard. Hard, really hard. Go, 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 go. As much as you can, Chris. As much as you can get. Kate, that's good.
We'll take the top one off there and we'll roll over. Still hang around. We've been in the center guard here for Team Thompson. This is event number 5 of 5 on the BC Women's Curling Tour, which is presented by Bel Air Direct Insurance and Best Western, the official hotel of Curl BC. The men's side, there's still one more event after this. It's the Ashley Home Stores Classic over
okay,
in
whoa,
Penticton.
Whoa, whoa.
Great over field over there. You have all the BC best teams here in BC, Sean Giel, Tyler Tardy, Jim Cotter. Team Wendick's going to be there, Dangerfield, Wood as well. But plus, you got Jacobs, McEwen, Cooey, Dunstone, Botcher. Did I say Gushu? Maybe I did, maybe I did, but he's going to be there in Penticton in 2 weekends. Got Bruce Moat from Scotland, a fantastic field in Penticton.
Yep.
So if you're in the area, definitely worth checking out. Unfortunately,
really,
we will
really
not be,
go, really
we personally
really
won't be
Jen.
Streaming the games there,
okay,
but there will be a,
okay,
will be
that's fine.
Another way
that's
to
fine.
View the games.
10-5.
That's coming up in 2 weekends. I think after this event, I believe our next scheduled event to be streamed will be Junior Provincials at the end of December in Victoria. You know, maybe we might end up doing a play down or two in December, you never know. So again,
yes,
keep a tab on Curl BC social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter for all updates of future streaming. So be sure to subscribe to our YouTube page here, which you're currently on. That way you can receive updates.
Good sweep.
And that way you'll know when
do you like this?
We're streaming.
What do you like? Do you like that?
So it is still the Yellow Rock at the back of the four, sitting shot. You can hit this.
I like here.
And trying to figure out the weight. You are going to play a hit on it. If you can, roll away. Create some separation between some red rocks. Don't want to peel the red ones out.
Yep, yep! Hard! Really have to push! You really have to push hard, really hard! Really,
running
really,
now to
really
make the
hard.
Red one
go,
go into
go,
the
go.
Yellow. Will just over curl. It will roll behind. Still the yellow one sitting shot stone. Back to four, and Carla's gonna ask Jody here for a guard. Sure she came up light on her last one. sit down for him. And we'll come to the top of the 12 foot. Try to remove this shot stone here, roll a bit to the right, sit two.
Yep. Hard. Push hard, Jen. Okay, whoa. Kelsey, go. Hard, right over Kels. Go. Good scrub.
We'll hit it out and then we'll roll.
Sorry,
it.
Sorry, I just had to be safe with it.
Red Rock is sitting shot right now. It's not easy.
I guess we just come here.
For Team Thomas to remove,
really
it's perfectly buried, so it looks like you're
helpful?
All. All you can do
you
is draw
really
in.
Yeah.
Draw the
no,
T-line if you can back four.
I wanted it to
almost
be safe.
Replace your rock.
Yeah.
Just bury it a little
big.
More.
So I didn't want to leave it and then just clip the front one. This is good though.
Okay, T like back four.
Drawing is really hard right now.
We want to try to bury it, so. It should go nice at the
yeah.
end, so.
One needs to curl 14. Up for here for Team Thompson. Waits pretty close and just doesn't curl for him, and it's going to slide to the back
one,
8 foot.
Just
so Team
like
Mork is sitting
it,
shot.
Right?
Oh, okay, because Lena was.
Yeah, I don't think you have much
to
hit and roll. Except,
to
except only to play like a hit and roll.
But that's okay. Wait was pretty close.
No drawing. Not going to do you too good because, again, you're going to give Team Thompson
Kelsey's
a rock to freeze on. And
Kristen threw her second one.
Either set
one
themselves
really
up
nice.
To steal or
so it just ran a little
limit
bit
Team Work down
so
to a single
I took
point.
Pretty
here,
much
so
the same
this
eight
one keeps two into play,
and
then
fighting eight.
I think mostly Carla might just hit the open one and
11.
Give up her deuce. Well, then she will trail by four.
So like,
I don't think she's
going to
go all in for it yet.
If you're light, I think curls.
This one will hit and they will roll a little bit the other way.
I think pretty much the same, hey?
Yeah. A little down. Yeah. I don't think mine was as positive as yours was either.
So the same shot, do have some backing here.
Okay.
Had the weight
okay.
on her last one, did Carla Thompson, so.
It's hard to call those at the
just
end.
Just put the broom in a different spot.
Pick the broom up and then it starts going
and
sideways.
You know, sit right on
if
top,
she makes
even
it perfect,
if you just
I
draw
to
the tee line.
It,
tighter here, but still hanging out there, taking his time. Now they're on it to make a curl. Gotta get by the top one first. It's gonna curl too much and it will bounce off.
11.
And will sit at the top of the button, but Sarah Work will have
a
shot
a
for three if she can get to the
here.
Inside of this one.
A little bit
All she has to do is stick around full 12 foot. She'll get a three ball here in six. Take a five-point lead.
Just a little bit less weight. And
but I wasn't super positive. We got a cross nose, though.
You have to cross your nose. You're going to jam on the one at the back, and you're only going to end up with two.
Maybe.
Thinking of
this is a hard
clean
shot.
Here.
The 11?
Yeah.
That does look hard because the rock on the top of the 12.
A little softer on the second
yeah.
one.
Even if we grab the back one, we get
go
the one, and that's
softer.
What we want at this end.
A little less, I think I said.
Comfy? Easy comfy.
So they're just going to pick it clean here instead. Take their two. This is the easier shot.
I don't think they were pounding
yeah.
it. Her body was turned, wasn't it? Oh.
So Sarah Work want to deliver the final stone here in six.
She's just peeling it out, I think, eh?
Picking it clean. Looks pretty good. We'll take the back one, and it'll just get her single here in six. She'll take a three-point lead heading to the seventh end here in Kelowna at the Sunset Ranch. Double K.
My hearing isn't that bad.
Stop making excuses and do something about your hearing loss. Connect Hearing offers solutions that are discreet, reliable, and cost-effective. Book your free hearing test today.
This is so fun. I don't know, man.
Down to the final two ends here. Draw number four of the Sunset Ranch.
Yeah, that works.
Kelowna double cash here inside the Kamloops. The
remember
Kelowna Curling Club. Kelowna. It's Kelowna,
not
the other one. Jordan Kiss with you. It's been a long day, folks. This is our fourth game. We've been at this current club since 8 o'clock, since
it
almost
wasn't?
7 o'clock this morning here. So
well, I would hope not.
It's been quite long
I
for us.
Not.
So the first right rock for
Brown,
our teamwork came up short. Going to be a corner guard here from Lynette Nordic. Try again and throw another center guard. Team Thompson looking to score two here in seven. was a final over on sheet 10. Team Slattery defeating Team Giles.
That was a really
team
good
Slattery
guess.
Now 2
that
and 0.
That was a really good
0.
Guess.
Team Giles good. 0 and 2. I think Team Giles are right next to me. I think they're laughing at me. I can't really tell right now. It's all fun and games here.
Yep! Hard line! Hard line!
So after Jen drew to the back of the bun, Lynette going to try to come around her corner guard, and it's going to rack on it.
What'd you get for those two splits?
I'm telling you, I got a force
for both of them. I just thought maybe the second one was slow.
Kelsey Jones filling in here this weekend for Team Wark. Of course, Carly Sand with their normal second in Quebec, coaching the BC team at the Canadian Mixed Championships.
Jen. Okay, here's fine. Good sweep, guys. Just came down, eh? 14-2.
Teamwork sitting two. Chance to play a hit and roll behind the staggered corner guards. Jamming it will roll a little bit, but still wide open here for Kelsey. Gonna try a little roll away. Nose is all right. Update over on sheet 4 in the Carter Montgomery game. Looks like they are in the 7th end. The score was 3-2 for Carter after 5, but they haven't put up the 6th end score yet. Thank you, Peter, for your comment there. As soon as they put up the score in the 6th end, I'll let you know.
Clean! I don't... Close! Yep!
And the red one will hang on. So Connor Montgomery game.
No, you'll get it.
They're just on the second rocks there in the 7th. Figure out who gets what rock as 3 rocks go. And
oh.
It's an open house.
Just kidding. Draw
Looks like the yellow one there is just hanging on, not out. Not much to draw around there. What? It's there. Are you playing in off? Play the freeze. Sit on top of it.
Okay, just it's good.
So we'll come up short and it'll be appeal here for Kristen.
Clean. Yep. Well, you can clean, you can clean, you can clean. Nice toss.
Perfectly executed. Maybe another freeze opportunity here for Jody. Some other finals early on the
that one did go out.
Men's side of things. I do believe Team Jackson defeated Team Dangerfield and Team Tardy defeating Team Wood.
It probably looked worse down there, but they were like this far apart.
Okay, yeah. Oh, it's not gonna make it.
Good take. Just nine.
So again, that one a little short from Team Thompson.
Kind of nice if we stick around because then we'll.
That was a better throw.
So Sarah now maybe thinking of trying to stick around here and trying to force to one. That way they'll have the hammer up to you coming home.
What was your first one? 72. It's getting heavy there.
Maybe even still wouldn't mind a blank in this end as well. Up, you know, up three without
obviously,
still a very good position
cute,
to
if
be in.
We can stay in. It's an easier force. But
funny,
then we'll
that.
Be in front of
getting
our other one,
over.
And she can draw to the back
like
one.
Too far
yeah,
the
comfy. Little less.
At least that'll be one.
Good,
maybe
good
we
call,
can,
man.
Like look on YouTube. That'll be one we can maybe look on YouTube just to show.
Yep.
I barely yelled anything today.
They are gonna go straight for the peel here.
Whoa!
Will hits, and are they gonna roll, or they're gonna? Yeah, they are
I'm
rolling.
Just not throwing those good,
and they're
man.
Gonna stick in there.
I know.
So force
I'm
is
not
on.
Very nice.
Sarah Wark just not in her best game here today. Against the ice has been tricky as well. That kind of gets in your head.
I need like just a peel practice.
Okay.
I know, and I don't. I'm not popping like I used to. Because I think I used to slide tight and fade back to the broom.
You were at the beginning.
So another opportunity at the freeze.
And fading back, yeah.
Third time's the charm here for Team Thompson.
Yeah.
We'll have to wait and see.
Very creative, Sarah.
Got a little more weight to it. It's coming down at the end. That's pretty
okay,
good.
I'm gonna throw this nice.
Oh, right on the nose.
Good sweep.
You don't care if you get rid of the back one. As long as you're sitting two after this, you'll call this a made shot.
I like that I get to throw it again, at least so I can fix whatever I just did. Huh? Yeah, just pick it out. And this time I'm gonna throw it right at the broom.
Okay.
Crazy.
Three.
It's great having these players mic'd up, isn't
Whoa!
It?
Whoa! Whoa!
Looks like they're just gonna pick this yellow one out here, and they will.
Oh my god.
Well, I suppose
I'm
the same
so
shot
bad
again
right now.
So, draw for one here for Carla
so
Thompson.
Bad. What was
and
that?
She'll trail by two heading
Did
into
I hit
the
hit
final
the
end.
I didn't feel like I hit
oh,
the room.
Oh, no, you actually hit the room on that one.
Oh god, I felt wide. Maybe
yeah,
it's
two
my
lines
eyes
good.
Right now. I need to fix. I slid out and I was like, well, I tried to line up a little bit wider since I've been sliding tight, but then I slid out and I was like, nope, nope. Those are usually my my bread and butter. What's going on?
Well, Carla Thompson, her last rock here in seven. Needs a nice little piece of the 8 foot to get her single. And she will do just that. So score one for Team Thompson. They'll trail by two heading into the final end. Sarah Wark will have the hammer here in Kelowna at the
right
Sunset Ranch.
Miles ago, Jim.
Shouldn't we be going faster?
Nah, with Bel Air Direct, you can save money on your optional car insurance by driving safely.
Up to 25%.
Slow and steady, champ.
Save up to 25% for safe driving on your optional car insurance with Bel Air Direct.
This isn't just a beer. This is a double-aged, never-back-down, full-of-heart Western beer. This is a beer brewed by 16 guys who risked it all. Original 16. Underdogs since 1989.
And number eight set to get underway here in Kelowna. Team Wark with a 2-point lead with the hammer. As Lynette Nordic will kick us off. Sunset Ranch double cash. Fifth and final event on the BC Women's Curling Tour. Presented by Bel Air Direct Insurance and Best Western.
Good sweep.
Jordan Kiss with you. Don't forget, our next game will be tomorrow morning.
Do you like this ice?
Guess in an hour it'll be this morning. Hopefully we don't go that long. Well, that would be great. But tomorrow morning, we're just gonna say tomorrow morning, 10 a.m. Team Jonies versus Team Richard.
I can
move action on the men's side. That's 10 a.m. tomorrow.
Hard, all the way over. You're almost there. Push hard. Go, 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 go. Hard, hard, hard. Oh, sorry,
and
bud.
And just go
good
on
try.
By. So a chance to put the double center guards for Team Thompson. Sheet six, another final. Team Wenzik defeating Team Richard. Team Wenzik now 3-0. Team Richard, I believe 2-1. So the win there, Team Wenzik at least guarantees themselves a tiebreaker.
If we tick, that's okay. It's really long.
So we're gonna try for another tick here. And finally put up the score on the sixth end over on sheet four between Team Cotter and Team Montgomery. And it looks like Team Cotter put up a deuce in six. They have a 5-2 lead over Team Montgomery.
Yep.
So they play seven.
Hard kills. Really hard. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Yep, keep going. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Kristen, roll.
Just a quick update then on the other games.
Hard roll, Chris.
Jen makes the tick and the yellow rock goes out. Oh, that is absolutely perfect. Out of the house, but not out of play. So great shot from Jen. So updates will roll through as there's less games than that update on. Sheet number five, Team Medford versus Team Longworth. They're tied. No, it's Team Medford with a 2-point lead in the eighth end. Sheet 17, Richards versus Team Hedima. Team Hedima has a 1-point lead as they play seven. Sheet 9, Team Margarine versus Team Ebby. Team Ebby scoring in four straight ends, 4, 5, 6, and 7, to have a 7-4 lead over Team Margarine of Russia.
Yep, yep.
Sheet
really
11.
Really gotta push, Jen.
That's Team
really
Kaufman leading
push,
5-2
hard.
Over
go,
Team
go, go,
O
go, go. Hard brush, Chris.
Of Korea.
Right over, yep.
And Sheet
nice.
12. Team Kiwana of Japan up 3-2 over Diane Gushelak as they are on skip rocks in the eighth end. Throw a guard on this one in the house here. Kelsey's going to be asked to peel again. Again, Team Thompson hoping for a miss. At least give themselves a chance. Near an eight.
Yep. Yep. Hard. Really hard. Go, 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 go. Oh, man, this is curling a lot. This is curling a ton.
This might be
yeah,
the miss
go, Chris,
they
go,
need
Chris,
here.
Go.
They will hit and they will roll towards center. So Team Thompson now has a guard they can work with. So they're going
to
come just behind it here on the center line. You could go in, but you don't want to leave a double. So they are just going to throw up another center guard as we're on to third rocks here in eight. So
again?
We do have a final. Sheet 11, Team Kaufman of Alberta defeating Team O of Korea.
How does this happen?
I don't know.
Final on sheet 9, Team Ebby defeating Team Margarine. Team Ebby now 1-1. Margarine 1-1 as well. Team team are going to discuss this
if
here.
That
the two guards are up.
Yeah.
You could hit the open
hit the
one.
Open one. They go around. The guards are still pretty long.
Maybe thinking of double peeling here.
We hit. She hits.
I think she's drawn. 100%. They need to steal two. They draw behind. We can play the double run, and if we peel, that's okay.
Yeah, if we do the hit roll, are we in front of the team?
No, we're behind. Just behind.
It's a hard draw.
It's a hard draw right now. We can roll further. Yeah. But even then, yeah, roll away.
They are going to decide to hit the open one and just roll away.
You know what? We would be just above T.
Maybe roll in now.
Yep.
Sarah comes into the house. They're saying they're going to roll in because they are above the T line. Because they don't want to be behind T here. So they're going to hit and roll in. Even if he knows, that's fine. Gotta make this
really
one.
Gotta go, guys.
Hit this one harder. Again, hit it, and they
this
will
crazy,
hit.
Man.
They will hit it out, but they will roll out. So, they'll allow Team Thompson to make a nice draw here around these two guards.
No, 10-1.
Already lost this one. Again, that spot's been filling these teams.
Okay, we need guards.
Hasn't been the easiest.
Ted, it's okay, we need guards.
So a nice line of guards there. And Sarah,
yeah, you're just throwing
gonna go shot. Out and peel them as Carla's gonna have to make two perfect ones on her last to hopefully force an extra end
like
here.
Keep going. Really hard. Really
make
hard.
Make it
you
the other way
you
here. At least trying to get one. Saying it picks. And,
this is so fun.
Sarah. You're okay. It's going. You're okay.
A little rush there. It's all good.
You've never yelled at me so aggressively in your life.
So Carla's going to have to make two really nice ones here.
Like top four is good. It's just
no,
be
it picked. It was like 2 feet out of your hand when it moved. Because at the beginning, I thought we were just nosing it.
90?
95. Yeah.
I was concerned when I let it go.
I know, me neither.
And then it was not.
I know.
All right, let's bury it nicely. Cool.
Yeah.
First rock here for Carla Thompson at 8. Needs two to steal. Got nothing in the house right now. Needs both her rocks to count.
Hard
she wants to take this to an extra
gone.
End. They're hard on it right now to get by the guards. You got to get it in
keep
the
it
rings here. Got to get it in the rings.
Keep it going.
Lynette and Amanda working hard on it. It will come to the top of the 8-foot. Sarah seeing if she can see in a piece of it.
Do we play the top one maybe? And then if I double peel, that's okay?
That's maybe a hair soft. Yeah.
I don't know if I can see enough. Do you think I can get it? This much?
Jen! You make it go away, you win the game. Well, if you really wanted to, you could even just draw in.
Yeah, if I get the top one, that's
it's fine. It's a tricky draw.
Yeah.
And then, you know, if you make it gray, you're really going to put the pressure on Carla to. She'll have an extremely difficult shot because she's going to need to sit two after. If you draw in there.
Peel.
It's not the ideal call, but if you're a little gutsy here, you know, it's definitely worth worth a try.
Well, no, I don't want to get fancy because if we rip that top guard, that's fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Still got room to put another one behind it.
Let's just make this, guys. I'll throw it nice.
Sarah Roar trying to pick this rock that Carla just threw and win the game. And they will just tick the yellow guard. So, still some hope here for Team Thompson.
So close.
I think the same ice. I think that was a
pitch
shot.
So the same shot almost, come a little deeper. You could see an extra end here.
Behind it. I felt like I was a little bit soft with my release one, so I think if I throw it a bit crisper.
I feel like I can't. Let's see where this one goes.
All right, last rock here for Carla
looks
Thompson.
Pretty terrible down there.
A little more weight, and she's going to have to make a really nice one on her last to win. Good news for Team Work. Worst case scenario, it is an extra end.
Hard Amanda.
We're on it now. It's diving towards the red one here. Gotta get it a bye. And it will not. And it will be handshakes. Team Work picking up the victory here, 6-4. Over Team Thompson and draw four
That's
of the Sunset
there,
Ranch Kelowna double cash. Team Work now going to 2-0. Team Thompson 0-2. And that will wrap it up for our day one coverage here in Kelowna.
Rough.
We back again tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock. Team Joni's versus Team
ice.
Richard
and
on the men's side. From
That's what my girls are saying too.
Our producer, director Marcio, Jessica, myself, Jordan Kiss, thank you for joining me here this afternoon, and we'll talk to you tomorrow.